Notice what happens, verse 3. And Israel joined himself unto Baal Peor, and the anger of the Lord was kindled against Israel. And the Lord said unto Moses, take all the heads of the people, hang them up before the Lord against the sun, that the fierce anger of the Lord may be turned away from Israel. And Moses said unto the judges of Israel, slay ye every one his men that are joined unto Baal Peor. You say that's extreme remedy. It certainly is. And you know why? Because the disease is fatal. It'll turn a man away from God and send him to hell. And therefore, what God was doing was an act of mercy to save the nation Israel. And we find there in verse 9, and those that died in the plague were 24,000. You see, that's the way that Balaam was able to curse Israel. And this is the doctrine of Balaam. And it got into the church. That's what the Lord says in Revelation 2:14. It got into the church. And it's in the church today. Now, my viewpoint is that you can't hurt God's people or God's work or God's church today from the outside. The church has never been hurt from the outside. The world in Pergamos came in like a flood, and the devil joined the church. And this is a great principle, I think, that's applicable to all relationships. You know, our country today, after World War II, we stuck up missiles everywhere and had a dew line across the Arctic, everything to keep the enemy from the outside. And what happened? We began to fall from the inside, and there was a moral decay, the like of which we've never seen. And today we find revolutionaries on the inside of our nation today. We'll be destroyed from within. Rome didn't fall from the outside. No enemy from the outside destroyed Rome, but Rome fell from within. And the church cannot be hurt from the outside, but it certainly can be hurt from within. And I find out that the same is true of any work today. It's always hurt from the inside and never from the outside. Have you ever noticed that the Lord Jesus was betrayed from the inside? It wasn't a Roman soldier that betrayed him. It was one of the apostles who betrayed him. And then his own nation turned him over to Rome to be crucified. Always, Jesus is betrayed from the inside. And friends, that's true today. That's the doctrine of Balaam, and it's a damnable doctrine, of course.